kam devo dar atunci mașina ce mai. Da, da. Stai pe stai pe. Stai așa, că mai vreau să stai.
Walter, come on, man. I'm short-handed. I need you outside to do some wipe downs. Come on.
What?
I said I need you outside to do some wipe downs. Are you here to work or to be staring at the skies? Come on. Let's go. Come on, man.
Fuck you, Bogdan.
What?
I said fuck you and your eyebrows. Wipe down this.
$20 million.
Okay, Mr. Wolinitz, this...
This is the price for Walter White.
Ah.
Oh, yes. You don't think I know who you are? I remember.
Well, I have not pretended to be an...
Your husband. He quit without giving me notice. He broke my air fresheners. He cursed at me and grabbed himself. And now he wants to buy my car wash. But he's not man enough to come in here and face me himself. Instead, he sends his woman.
Excuse me?
Walter White wants to buy my car wash. The price he pays is $20 million. Now, please leave.
Can I talk to you for a second?
Sure. So I wanted to thank you for this opportunity.
Oh, pleasure.
But yeah, the job, it's not really for me.
You're joking.
No. I quit.
Wow. Cocky little shit. Then what are you gonna go play house with that ugly little girlfriend of yours?
Maybe I will.
Well, maybe you will. But let me tell you something. You won't, because you won't have a job. Okay? So I want you to get prepared for what it feels like to be on the unemployment line. Because as of this moment forward, I'm going to do everything in my power to ensure that you never work in this town again. Hey, put that in your Facebook.
This working late one night, and I thought it was a good opportunity to express myself.
I just say it!
Merry Christmas.
Randy the Ram?
No.
Russell from the 80s? Ram Jam?
No.
That's freaky. You look just like the dude. Except older.
You little prick, you gonna talk to me the way you do?
Huh? Randy!
I fucking quit! I quit!
Look, man!
All right? Was a fucking cheese lady? Huh? Get your own fucking cheese!
Crazy!
I quit! God damn it, I quit! God, I'm out of here!
Oh.
Robin. Robin. Robin, man, it's Randy. Randy.
Car is loose.
Yeah, I know. Thank you for that. Toby runs that setup in De Leon. He won't finish, let alone win.
He's in?
Maybe.
Look, we have a plan.
What does that mean?
Means we know what we're doing. Get your ass down here, bitch.
Casual Friday.
Oh, Jackie. I've always wanted to do that.
Yeah. Have a nice day, you miserable bastards.
My friend's running the fastest Mustang in the world at De Leon on Sunday, and the setup's all wrong.
I'm in accounting. Oh.
Do you feel like you're dying inside?
Yes.
It's cold in here.
Where's the beast?
What the hell? Where are your clothes, man?
You missed this?
No, I didn't miss. Don't touch me, man. Stay away. We gotta go. Let's go.
You missed me, didn't you?
No.
Get up.
I've got the shaved bird. We're jumping in the beast.
All right, we're behind. We got 28 hours to get to Cali.
Copy that.
Good morning.
All right, so why the hell are you naked?
To make sure I'd never come back.
I'm sure you could have done that another way. Let's be clear, though. You're not wearing my underwear.
Are you threatening me?
No.
Get the fuck out of here. You're fired.
I have a better solution. You keep me on the payroll as an outside consultant. And in exchange for my salary, my job will be never to tell people these things that I know. I don't even have to come into the office. I can do this job from home.
Who the fuck do you think you are, you crazy little shit? Security?
I am Jack's smirking revenge.
Oh!
Oh! What the hell are you doing? Oh!
Oh! That hurt.
Why would you do that? Oh my God! No! Please stop! What are you doing? Oh God, no, please! No!
For some reason, I thought of my first fight with Tyler.
No!
Inside everything this man took for granted, something horrible had been growing.
Now look, just give me the paychecks like I asked, and you won't ever see me again.
And right then, at our most excellent moment together.
Oh, thank God. Please don't hit me again. Please.
telephone, computer, fax machine, 52 weekly paychecks, and 48 airline flight coupons. We now had corporate sponsorship. This is how Tyler and I were able to have Fight Club every night of the week.
Man, you're pushing your luck, okay?
No worries.
That was dumb, man.
Hey, Harold, you worry too much, you know? You're gonna have a heart attack. You act like that guy's doing you a favor or something.
What was this with the Colombians, man?
Eh? What does it matter?
What does it... He says Colombians and you make these eyes like... What?
I don't like fucking Colombians, okay?
Hey, hey, what you guys doing? That's a lot of dishes to be washed.
Washing yourself, right?
Cuño.
I retire.
What the fuck you gonna do that now?
Somebody I gotta look after my investment.
Fuck you guys, man.
Close the shop, Mike. Did you ever see that movie where the body is walking around carrying its own head, and then the head goes down on that bay?
Reanimator.
Look, I'm not paying you to do whatever it is you're doing out here.
Fine. So don't pay me.
Excuse me?
I quit. So you don't have to pay me. Now leave me alone.
Asshole.
I think you just became my personal hero. Doesn't that make you nervous, just quitting your job like that? Well, I guess when you're all of, what, 16?
18. I just do these gigs as a cover. I have other sources of income. But my dad interferes less in my life when I pretend to be an upstanding young citizen with a respectable job.
Lester? What are you doing?
Honey, this... Ricky. This is Ricky.
I'm Ricky Fitz. I just moved in the house next to you. I go to school with your daughter.
With Jane?
Yeah.
Really?
Jane.
Hi. I'm ready to go. I'll meet you out front.
I'm in trouble. Nice meeting you, Ricky Fitz. Thanks for the thing.
Anytime. Lester, if you want any more, you know where I live.
My job consists of basically masking my contempt for the assholes in charge and at least once a day retiring to the men's room so I can jerk off while I fantasize about a life that doesn't so closely resemble hell. Well, you obviously have no interest in saving yourself.
Brad, for 14 years I've been a whore for the advertising industry. The only way I could save myself now is if I start firebombing.
Whatever. Management wants you gone by the end of the day.
Well, just what sort of severance package is management prepared to offer me, considering the information I have about our editorial director buying pussy with company money, which I think would interest the IRS since it technically constitutes fraud, and I'm sure that some of our advertisers and rival publications might like to know about it as well, not to mention Craig's wife.
What do you want?
1 year salary with benefits.
That's not going to happen.
Well, what do you say I throw in a little sexual harassment charge to boot?
Against who?
Against you. Can you prove that you didn't offer to save my job if I let you blow me?
Man, you are one twisted fuck.
Nope. I'm just an ordinary guy with nothing to lose.
Wait, please,
I love this job.
Arthur, I need to know why you brought a gun into a kid's hospital.
It's a prop. It's part of my act now.
That's bullshit! Bullshit! What kind of clown carries a fucking gun? Besides, Randall told me you tried to buy a 38 off him last week.
Randall told you that?
You're a fuck-up, Arthur. And a liar. You're fired.
I read it was a guy in full makeup.
No, it says right here it was a mask.
Either way, I think it's good for business. They got clowns in front of every newspaper.
Big man, what's the good word?
Hey. Hey, Arthur. I heard what happened. Sorry, mate.
Yeah. Doesn't seem fair. Getting fired like that.
Did you really bring a gun to the children's hospital, Artie? What the fuck would you do that for?
Is that part of your new act, Arthur? If your dancing doesn't do the trick, you're just gonna shoot yourself?
Why don't you ask Randall about it? It was his gun.
What?
I still owe you for that, don't I?
What the fuck are you talking about? Stop talking out of your ass, Art.
Oh, no! I forgot to punch out.
But what if this isn't what I want? I mean, what if I don't want to live the way you live?
Oh, don't be ridiculous, Andrea. Everybody wants this.
Everybody wants to be us.
Is that your car on the lot?
Yeah.
It's a nice ride.
Thanks, man.
Donny Azoff.
Hey, Jordan Belfort. Nice to meet you. Yeah.
You know, actually, I see that car around. I see it around a lot.
Well, you know,
I think we live in the same building.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. 12th floor?
Yeah. What floor are you on?
4th floor. Yeah, for little kids.
Right.
Ugly wife.
Yeah.
So what do you do, bro?
What do you mean, what do I do?
For work, what do you do?
I'm a stockbroker.
Stockbroker?
Yeah.
Children's furniture.
Oh, good for you.
It's all right. You make a lot of money?
Yeah, I do all right for myself.
I'm trying to put it together. You got your fucking nice car.
Mm-hmm.
We live in the same building. I'm not understanding how much money you make.
I don't know. $70,000 last month.
Get the fuck out of here.
I'm serious.
Yeah, no, I'm serious, too. Seriously, how much money you make?
I told you, 70,000. Well, technically 72,000 last month, something like that.
You made 72 grand in 1 month.
Yeah.
I tell you what, You show me a pay stub for $72,000 on it, I quit my job right now and I work for you. Hey, Paulie, what's up? No, yeah, no, everything's fine. Hey, listen, I quit.
And he did quit his job.
Yeah, yeah, no, I'm grabbing.
Which I thought was a little weird. I mean, I just met this fucking guy.
Don't fucking tell Susan. It's none of her business.
There were other things about him, too, like his phosphorescent white teeth.
Wife, I gotta fucking deal with your wife.
The fact that he wore horn rims with clear lenses just to look more waspy. And then there were these rumors.